Last time we talked about how to integrate over a type 1 region and how to integrate over a type 2 region. Of course, in the real world, people don't say, this is type 1 or this is type 2. You have a region and you have to figure out for yourself whether it's type 1 or type 2. So let's suppose we're talking about a triangle bounded by the x-axis, y equals x, and x equals 2. That's a triangle, three sides. Is it a type 1 or type 2? Well, the fact is, it's both. Here's our triangle. It's between the x-axis, the line x equals 2, and the line y equals x. You can think of it as the line y equals x. You can also think of it as the line x equals y. If you want to think of it as type 1, you can draw a bunch of columns. You say each column starts at y equals 0 and goes up to y equals x. And then the leftmost column is at x equals 0, and the rightmost column is at x equals 2. But you could also do it in terms of rows. You could say you've got a whole bunch of rows, and each row starts at x equals y and goes all the way up to x equals 2. So there are two ways to write an integral over the region R. If you want to think of it as a type 1 region, you can write the integral as the integral from y equals 0 to y equals x. You integrate over y, and then that'll tell you what's in a column, and then you go, the leftmost column is at 0, the rightmost column is at 2, so I integrate the columns from 0 to 2. But if you prefer, you could group everything into rows, and you say each row starts at x equals y and goes up to x equals 2. So you integrate as x goes from y to 2, your function dx, and that gives you what is in a row. And then you integrate the rows. The bottom row is at y equals 0. The top row is at y equals 2. And so you want to integrate as y goes from 0 to 2. Two ways to do it. And so, whenever you have two ways to do something, the obvious question is, which is better? And the answer is, it depends on what it is you're trying to integrate. So, for example, suppose we want to integrate e to the x squared. You could try doing it as a type 2 integral, in which case you'd wind up with the integral from 0 to 2 of the integral along each row, x goes from y to 2 of e to the x squared dx. And to do that, you'd have to figure out an antiderivative of e to the x squared. And I'll bet you don't know any antiderivatives of e to the x squared. Because I don't either, and nobody does. There is no function you can write down in closed form whose derivative is e to the x squared. You could define a function to be the integral of e to the x squared, but that doesn't do you any good. It's not computable. So if you can't figure out, do the inner integral, doing the double integral seems hopeless. On the other hand, if you do it the other way, if you do it as a type 1 integral, it works out just fine. You integrate as y goes from 0 to x, e to the x squared dy. Well, you're integrating dy, so e to the x squared is just a constant. You get e to the x squared times y. You evaluate that at y equals 0 and y equals x. And you just get x e to the x squared minus 0 e to the x squared. Well, that's just x e to the x squared. And integrating x e to the x squared dx, well, that's pretty easy. You just do a u substitution with u equals x squared, du equals 2x dx, and you get that the answer is e to the u over 2. That's e to the x squared over 2, evaluated at 2 and at 0, gives you e to the fourth minus 1. Over 2. Not so bad. Now, if we'd picked a different function, if we'd been trying to integrate, say, f of xy is sine of 2 minus y squared, then doing it this way would be very, very hard, and doing it this way would be easy. Which one is easier depends on what is the function you're trying to integrate. So you need to learn how to do both type 1 and type 2, because there are times when you need one of them, there are times when you need the other. In fact, there are times when you're given one and you want to convert it to the other. This is called swapping the order of integration. So we're going to look at something where somebody hands you a type 2 integral, and we're going to convert it into a type 1 integral, and we're going to solve it. So our problem is to compute the integral from y goes from 0 to 4 of the integral as x goes from root y to 2 of cosine pi x cubed over 16 dx dy. You look at that and say, do I know a function whose derivative is cosine of pi x cubed over 16? I can't think of one. It's conceivable that there's some way to find one. I don't know for sure that it can't be written in closed form, but I bet it can't. This is just too darn hard. So you can't do it directly. In this answer, first question, can you do it directly? No. So instead, we're going to draw a picture of the region of integration. So we say, we are trying to integrate as x goes from square root of y. Let's see, x equals square root of y looks kind of like that, because x equals square root of y is another way of saying y equals x squared. We're going from x equals square root of y to 2. So we're each row, we're going from square root of y to 2. And then we're taking the lowest row at y equals 0. That's this 0. The top row is at y equals 4. So in fact, our region is everything between this parabola, this line, and this line. Can we rewrite that as a type 1 integral? Sure. We just have to figure out what our columns are like. Our columns start at y equals 0 and go up to y equals x squared. Our leftmost column is at x equals 0. Our rightmost column is at x equals 2. So, converting our double integral over the, we start out with an iterated integral, we converted it into a double integral over a region, and now we express that double integral as the integral as x goes from 0 to 2, of the integral of y goes from 0 to x squared, of our function, cosine of pi x cubed over 16 dx, let's say dy dx. And then the question is, can we actually do the rewritten integral? Well, yeah, we can. The inner integral is pretty darn easy because this is just a constant. It doesn't depend on y. So the inner integral just gives us x squared cosine of pi x cubed over 16. And then to do that, we do a u substitution. We let u equals pi x cubed over 16. Du is 3 pi x squared over 16 dx. And we say, hey, this is the integral of 16 over 3 pi cosine of u du. And let's see, when x is 0, u is 0. And when x is 2, u is pi times 8 over 16. That's pi over 2. And that's not a bad integral at all. That's just sine of u times 16 over 3 pi. Evaluated u equals 0 and u equals pi over 2. And that gives us 16 over 3 pi. So doing the integral in one direction worked just fine. Doing the integral in the other direction was hopeless. By going from an iterated integral to a double integral and then to a different iterated integral, we can solve what is otherwise a really hard problem.